Today, I cover weeks 33 and 34 of my client Vivian's reverse diet series. She tests her one rep maxes, and I talk about rep ranges. Hey, this is Colin DeWay. If you want to master your metabolism and create forever results, start now by subscribing and click on that bell notification so you don't miss anything. So in the last update, I was talking about how Vivian started taking creatine and how most people will see a little bit of an increase on the scale as their muscles become more saturated. I also mentioned that it usually takes about 1 to 2 weeks for the muscles to totally saturate, and most people see somewhere around 1 to 3 pounds in weight gain as they get started. Anyway, I thought it would be good to remind you of that because it will help you understand some of the things that have happened here and some of the reasons for the decisions that I've made based on what has occurred. You'll see for week 33 that she gained about 1.05 pounds, which is a pretty big increase for her, but it's also almost exactly 2 weeks after starting creatine, so there's a pretty decent chance it's creatine related. And as I mentioned last week, this is actually good weight and nothing to be concerned about. Not only that, but we were getting ready to taper her as she was at the end of her training block, so there's a decent chance that fatigue was high, body's carrying a little bit of extra inflammation, and that can show up on the scale as well. So all that to basically say that, as you probably expected, we just kept things the same, no changes in macros heading into week 34, and we just see how things go. As mentioned, we were getting ready to taper her so she could get good and recover so we could test her one rep maxes, and we were basically gonna go through what would be like a mock meet for powerlifting and test her strength. What this means is we reduced her training volume significantly while keeping her intensity high, which in this case, intensity meaning percentage of her one rep max, to make sure that she's keeping her strength and allow her to be at her best for meet day. And anytime you taper or go through a deload, you're gonna reduce some inflammation as you recover, and therefore you could see a reduction on the scale based on the body getting rid of some of that inflammation. But before I get into any actual weight changes, I'm gonna overlay some footage of her actual mock meet here so you can see, and overall things went really well and she hit some big PRs. Truth be told, she was off to a little bit of a rough start because she actually had to change a ruptured tire literally about a half hour before she was getting ready to meet, and obviously that's not gonna help with strength and energy, but hey, sometimes life just does that to you and it is what it is. So she ended up taking 260 pounds for her planned second attempt, and that actually went pretty well. But then when she went to do her final attempt of 280 pounds, she kind of got out of position and just wasn't able to grind it and ended up missing that lift. But we'll talk a little bit more about that in a bit. Then when she went on to bench press, her second attempt was 130 pounds and that moved okay. But then when she went up to her planned 140 pounds, it just ended up being too much on that day. And for all you power lifters out here, this is a valuable lesson, and it's one that I still make mistakes with sometimes, and this was the case here. You have to remember that training for the bench is a bit different than an actual meet where you have to go through the commands and everything else, and it's just a little bit more difficult with a good long pause at the bottom, and that can make it much more difficult. So even though she smoked 135 about a week ago when we were doing conservative maxing, 140 just was not there on this day. And you never know, could be some of the other factors such as the car tire and being fatigued from missing a squat. Anyway, from there she went on to deadlift and this went much better, and honestly that's been the lift that's just been really progressing very well for her, which has been nice because it was actually the lift that she kind of struggled with the most as we got started. So it's been really fun to see it come together, and her positioning and everything has improved so much, and it all showed mock meet day. So she ended up hitting not only a PR but a big milestone by deadlifting 300 pounds for her final attempt, which obviously had her pretty excited, as well she should have been, and it was just a really nice wrap up to an entire macro cycle. But she decided she wasn't done. She really wanted to go back and try squatting again, so she actually reduced it by 5 pounds, went to 275, which was actually the planned attempt for her, but she went up to 280, as I told her she felt good she could do that. And even though 280 wasn't there, she ended up hitting 275, which is pretty incredible if you think about it, because going through all that, going through the tire thing and an entire mock meet, fatigue was high, to be able to come back and actually hit it is pretty fantastic. Okay, so now that that whole macro cycle is done and we've gone through a good strength block and she's done her testing and strength has gone up quite a bit, it's now time to shift focus and really start working more on getting more volume in and focusing on building muscle. And this is why I want to talk about rep ranges today, because there seems to be a bit of a misunderstanding when it comes to what is the best for building, and that is that people think that it's just all about the moderate reps, kind of like the 8 to 12 rep range, but there's actually a lot of benefit of going through strength work to help with this. Now obviously it's a little bit different if you're not an actual powerlifter like Vivian, and you don't necessarily have to go through an actual like peaking strength block to do one rep max testing, but there still is a lot of value in going through strength blocks and focusing on getting stronger for a little bit. So if you didn't know, a lot of people say to build strength you want to work in kind of like the 1 to 5 rep range, and then for building muscle it's more like 8 to 12 or maybe like 6 to 12, and then for building muscle endurance you want to go even higher than that. And while there's a degree of truth to all of that, at the same time research has shown that when it comes to actual muscle size, whether you do more strength work or more moderate rep ranges, as long as volume is equated, results in in hypertrophy or building muscle size is the same. But even though muscle size is the same, the lower rep work actually builds more strength, and if you can build more strength, you can then do more weight in the moderate rep ranges and therefore build more volume and build more muscle. But there's balance here, because like with the strength work, you're gonna have to do a lot more sets, you're gonna have to take a lot more rest, there's a bigger chance for injury, and it's just gonna be harder to create that much volume, so you don't necessarily wanna do just a crap load of volume with low rep work. And depending on what your goals are, but I find there's a benefit to doing all rep ranges, you just focus a little bit more specifically on whatever your actual goal is. So if your goal is building muscle, you're gonna stick to the more moderate rep ranges, but doing some work of the strength work is going to help, just like doing some of the higher rep work to build endurance is gonna help as well, and it all comes together. Or if you're more focused on strength and you do more of the low rep work, but you still wanna do some of the other stuff because it all comes together and you can build better work capacity and on and on and on. So I find that for most people, it's best to do all the rep ranges in different periods, but you just wanna be more specific to whatever your goal is. Okay, circling back to the reverse diet now, she actually did see a decrease of about 0.2 pounds from week 33 to week 34, but we have to remember that she went through an actual taper. We reduced her training volume significantly so that she could be rested and ready to go for her actual mock meet, so therefore she probably had a reduction in training inflammation, and that would probably explain why. So it'll be interesting to see how things go now, because she's going to be doing more volume and she will create a bit more expenditure from this as her workouts will be more intense, but at the same time, I don't think it adds up quite as much as a lot of people think, so I can really see it going either way. She could see a bump in the scale, especially as she gets a little bit more sore and creates more training inflammation, but at the same time, if she's burning more calories, she might see an actual little bit of a drop in weight. We'll just have to see how things go and make some adjustments accordingly, but for now, we're just gonna keep rolling and keep doing what we've been doing and adjust if necessary. So if you look back, she's been at the same macros now for the last 11 weeks, and she's seen an increase of about 4 pounds on the scale, which is a pretty good pace for her, considering that she wants to be in a building phase. And if we look at pictures from 11 weeks ago to now, you will see that there is a little bit of an increase in a bit of body fat, but nothing concerning at all. And we always have to expect that there's gonna be a little bit. If you wanna go through an actual building phase, we have to accept that that's gonna come with a little bit of body fat as well. And if you look at measurements over that time as well, there's been a little bit of an uptick, but nothing too concerning. And actually the one that I consider to be the most important when it comes to actual body fat is the waist measurement, and that's only up about a half a centimeter. And an increase in something like the hips could actually be a good thing, because booty gains. But overall, from the beginning to now, Vivian's been in a great place. We went through the reverse diet phase. We were able to get her metabolism to a much better spot. She actually lost weight for quite a while, and then things kind of evened out, but she's up over 800 calories and only up a couple pounds since the beginning. But of course, now that we're really focusing on building, that's gonna change, and we're gonna start seeing more weight gain as we've been seeing of late. She's been able to increase strength dramatically. She's been able to stay healthy, which was a big thing for her because she was coming back from some powerlifting injuries from before. And now she gets to put all this extra strength into action and focus on really building some good muscle as we focus on building for at least the rest of 2019, and we'll see how things go from there. All I know is whenever she does decide to cut down the road, she's gonna be in a great place to do so. Overall, I'm really excited about things. I can't wait to see how things go here, and I hope that you're taking some valuable lessons from this. The most important being that she is showing you the benefit of being really patient and the payoff that comes from that. And you're really gonna see that in action as we go through this entire process. By the way, if you wanna know how fast you should be increasing in weight if you're going through an actual building phase, or how to maintain the best you can as you go through a reverse diet process, then make sure you check out this video, and I'll break down how to do that for either scenario. If you're interested in getting coaching yourself, go to my website below, ColinTheWayTraining.com, click on online coaching and apply today. If you have any questions, just leave them in the comments below and I'll be sure to get back to you, and I'll see you next time.